We have individual speaker slots. About five speakers will be speaking here, and each one will be expressing their views and commitments on sustainability. We now have a special video address by Yuri Afanasyev, the representative of the UN in India. May I please request the video to be played?
Khadi is empowering the poorest of poor. Khadi go freedom fabric together. Khadi is national fabric also. Or may I say magic fabric. ये सवाल भी अक्सर पूछा जाता है why khadi? Because khadi is the most environmentally friendly fabric. The products are completely recyclable and biodegradable. It has zero carbon footprint. Additionally, manufacturing, most water efficient, शायद आपको मालूम नहीं होगा कि खादी का जब एक मीटर कपड़ा बनता है तो उसमें मात्र 3 लीटर पानी की जरूरत पड़ती है, लेकिन वही कपड़ा एक मीटर जब वेव में बनता है तो करीब 56 लीटर पानी की जरूरत पड़ती है. तो दिस मोस्ट डिमांड फैक्ट्री खादी से एक्टिव मॉडर्न टाइम्स इज सेफ because handsman and handwoman and it's friendly. It's fashionable, it's luxurious, it's simple. It is indigenous. It represents India's self-reliance, legacy, traditions, and pride of rural productivity. Khadi is heritage, humanity, and joy of India. It is rewarding.
And a champion of nature. The Amirza plays many roles with elan and ease. Dia's repertoire of work includes a host of blockbuster films, including the recent mega-successful film Sanju, and beauty pageant titles, positioning her amongst the most successful and versatile beauty icons and actors of our country. May we please welcome Dia.
Good morning, friends. It's an honor and a pleasure to be here on what I perceive as one of the most critical engagements that Lakme Fashion Week conducts. It's really encouraging to know that Lakme Fashion Week cares about the environment and is working towards sustainable goals and encouraging more people to expand their consciousness and their awareness of the impact that they have on our shared home. The only one we know, our planet. I stand before you today to explain a few things that some of the gentlemen have spoken about earlier in the simplest terms possible. We have been hearing these terms repeatedly in the recent past, because if we do not, each one of us, understand what these terms mean, it would be impossible for us to imbibe them and implement them in our lifestyle and in our everyday choices as producers and as consumers. So I hope to be able to explain that to you. But before I go into explaining what circular economy means in simple terms, I want to start with just painting a perspective, a very simple perspective that I share with little children when I do talks with them. So the perspective is this. 2.37% is the geographical landmass of India, our country. It's a very small part of a very beautiful planet. And on this 2.37% lives the world's second largest population. It's a very small land that has a very large number of inhabitants. And in this very small land with a large number of inhabitants, we all have needs, basic human needs. Need for water, primarily, need for food, and then comes the rest, clothing and shelter. But the primary need for every life to exist is water. And what is the birthing ground of our rivers and our water bodies is our forest cover, our green cover, that is less than 5%, which means that the dense and the protected forest areas, which is less than 5%, is supposed to be the birthing ground of rivers that is supposed to support the life of all our people and our existence. Which is why I'm so passionate about protecting our forests, our wildlife, and also encouraging more people to understand this very simple perspective. Because every action and inaction on our part has consequences on our environment. And we as human beings are not separate from our environment, and we're not separate from nature. We're a part of it and not apart from it. And everything that we do to the environment, we're in fact doing to ourselves. Which is what brings me to explaining why the circular economy and what is the circular economy. Unlike other species on our planet, we are the only species that produces kachra. Right? We make things that we dispose of, but thereby creating waste. And unfortunately, a lot of this waste that we create has nowhere to go. So a lot of it gets incinerated, which means it gets burnt, polluting our air, our soil, and our water. A lot of it lands up in landfills, creating all kinds of toxicity. A lot of it lands up, you know, you see it on the wayside, and then it eventually lands in our rivers, in our oceans, and our water bodies, creating serious amounts of pollution and toxicity. Earth, its resources, living things have been around for billions of years. In nature, there is, like I said, no waste generated. And every iota of waste that nature generates produces new life. So what, you know, the bark of the tree, when it falls, it mingles with the soil, it becomes rich nutrients, it feeds new organisms, and new life is born. And then, of course, this grows, it gets consumed or eaten by another living thing and eventually decomposes, and the nutrients return to the soil, making way for new things to come to life. And this way, the cycle of life begins again, hence a cyclical approach. So basically, everything in nature that creates waste goes back to giving life and nurturing new births. Therefore, it's a cycle of life. However, as humans, we have adopted a linear approach. We take, we make, and we dispose. Each time we dispose, the waste piles up. As we all know, Earth has finite resources. And as of 2 weeks ago, human beings have exhausted the resources that were made available to us by nature for the entire year, 2 weeks ago. So we've already exhausted what nature provides, like, even before the year has ended. As we all know, the Earth has finite resources, and collectively, this impacts our resource efficiency and sustainability. In the circular economy approach, each new object is designed for future reuse, and at the end of its life, it becomes a potential resource. Which means, if we as individuals, as human beings, can draw our consciousness to the materials that we're using to make the things that we consume, be it the food we eat, or the clothes we wear, or the homes we build, or the cars we use, whatever it is that we're using, can we find a way to use technology, science, innovation, and most importantly, creativity and empathy to make things that have an end life that don't destroy the life that the Earth provides. We need to redesign our products to ensure that the waste they generate builds capital rather than reduce it. This essentially means that we need to engage with all actors, designers, not the one that I am, but, well, we can engage too. But what I mean here is designers, producers, business, industries, retailers, to impact the complete value chain. So the idea is that when we build and we make, we use things that are earth-friendly right from the beginning, so that when the end of its life appears, it is not contaminating the environment and our water resources, and of course, killing us. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Dia, for the wonderful address. You did stick to your...
The problem with being the last speaker always is most of the points you want to raise have already been spoken.
We intend to promote the thought leadership in sustainability and circular economy by nurturing environmental champions of tomorrow. This will be fully designed, and post the launch, the condition is very simple. You need to make sure you take any waste, including plastic. It's not just fabric, but any waste, and find an upgradation of that waste through your design. Whoever wins this concept,
थोड़ा हाथ नीचे रख ला या तो पीछे आ जाओ
यस बोलो
अनिता
मैम एक साथ में
अनिता मैम
दिया मैम के साथ अरे इसको तो रद्दी खाली चाहिए मैम या दिया मैम यहाँ पे दिया मैम सोलो या
Ladies and gentlemen,
but
if you please request to make your way
to
the exit,
we need
to start preparations
for our next show. Thank you so much. Ma'am, wait.
Ma'am, look here.
Yeah, ma'am.
Special, right from your designers to your attendees to media to fashion industry connoisseurs, everyone really holds this day in a different on a different pedestal altogether. It's a very important conversation to have, sustainability, and the show that we got to see celebrating the beauty of the of our beauty and glory of India's fabric of freedom, khadi. Great presentation by four of our designers. Thank you so much for this beautiful presentation, the Khadi and Village Industries Commission. I would like to ask Mr. Vinay Saxena, the chairman, to please let us know what it was like putting this show together and how did this presentation come about?
Thank you. I think today is a historic day for Khadi. Because Khadi has got this platform, Lakme Fashion Week. मैं जितने भी यंग डिज़ाइनर्स हैं उन सबको बहुत बहुत मुबारकबाद देना चाहता हूं, थैंक्स देना चाहता हूं जिन्होंने बहुत ही सुंदर डिज़ाइंस आज जो हैं लैक्मे फैशन वीक में पेश किए. आज खादी ने ये प्रूव कर दिया कि वो वर्सटाइल है, फैशनेबल है, एथनिक है और उसके साथ साथ पीपल्स फैब्रिक है, नेशनल फैब्रिक है. आज जो प्लेटफॉर्म खादी को मिला है, मैं समझता हूँ कि आने वाले समय में खादी फ्रॉम लोकल टू ग्लोबल बहुत जल्दी हो जाएगा। ये एक विज़न है कंट्री का, जिसे आज देश के प्रधानमंत्री जो हैं आगे बढ़ा रहे हैं। मुझे यकीन है कि आज जो डिज़ाइंस हमारे यंग डिज़ाइनर्स ने पेश की वो इतनी सुंदर थी, वेरिएबल थी, कि आने वाले समय में जो है ये एक अलग से ही फैशन स्टेटमेंट बनकर सामने आएंगे। खादी ने इन पिछले कुछ सालों में अपने को बदलने की कोशिश की है, अपनी इमेज को बदलने की कोशिश की है। जो खादी शायद नेताओं या बुज़ुर्गों का कपड़ा कहा जाता था, उसे बदलने की कोशिश की है। और आज इस लैक्मी फैशन वीक में खादी का आना और उनके डिज़ाइनर्स का पेश होना, ये अपने में एक, मैंने जैसा पहले भी कहा, कि हिस्टोरिक डे है। मैं समझता हूँ कि आने वाले समय में हम लोग इस तरीके के फैशन शो में पार्टिसिपेट करते रहेंगे और खादी की जो इमेज है उसको चेंज करने में सफल होंगे। थैंक यू।